Disney continues Walt's legacy with their latest Disney Nature film. You're watching Beyond the Trailer's review of Bears.
From Disney Nature comes a story all parents share.
So gonna make this place yours.
About the love, the joy, the struggle, and the strength it takes to raise a family.
Trouble in my dragon.
In the 1950s, Walt Disney produced a series of feature films and shorts focusing on nature. They were called True Life Adventures, and Disney worked to turn the educational material into a brand, even spinning off a comic strip that ran until 1971. True Life Adventures was never a huge hit, financially or commercially, although the series did win 8 Oscars. But it was true Walt, as while he loved to entertain, he also always looked out for the best interests of his audience. Why not have fun and learn at the same time? Now, of course, that combination is most successful when the learning part is hidden, and True Life Adventures wore its educational goals on its sleeve. The same can be said for the new incarnation as well, Disney Nature. Founded in 2008, its offices are actually in Paris, the only Disney company to have its headquarters outside the United States. I wonder if they're neighbors with Illumination Entertainment's Paris Animation Studio. Anyway, Disney Nature's debut film Earth was a tremendous success, grossing over $100 million worldwide. And while none of Disney Nature's follow-up films have been able to duplicate that success, they have still become an annual tradition that has even inspired other studios to join in. For instance, Warner Brothers just released their own nature documentary, Island of Lemurs Madagascar, earlier the same month. This year, Disney Nature's entry is Bears, co-directed by Disney Nature superstar Alistair Fothergill. He co-directed Earth, along with 2011's African Cats and 2012's Chimpanzee. And Disney Nature has brought another superstar on board, Jane Goodall, who has been involved with their last several films. You'll notice that all these films come out in April for Earth Day, and as we begin to realize that zoos don't necessarily provide the pampered life we thought, perhaps nature documentaries like this are the future of how we learn about animals. Plus, as is another Disney Nature tradition, if you see bears opening weekend, part of the box office will be donated to help the animals and the natural environments you get to see in the film. So, is 40 minutes with Disney Nature's Bears as much fun as a trip to the zoo?
This is a nature documentary, all right. It's just you, John C. Reilly, some bears, a wolf, and a crow, which actually made me think of Game of Thrones. And it's more than 40 minutes. It's actually a little over an hour. And you might think to yourself, that's a long time to spend with just bears. It was a long time to spend with just bears. And I nodded off a few times, I have to admit. But that's because this movie was so super cozy. It was like snuggling in for a warm winter's nap yourself, which is ironic because in the movie they just awaken from their hibernation. But the film, it really is beautiful to watch. I thought that the Disney has spared no expense when making this movie. The cinematography is really stunning and the footage they get is impressive. You really get to know this mama bear and her cubs. It's amazing they were allowed to get this close. I talked to them. I did an interview with the bears. No, I did an interview with the two directors and Dr. Jane Goodall about the film. She's a special ambassador for Disney Nature, and they talked about how bears in a reserve like this, a protected reserve, are actually very friendly and not particularly threatened by humans. So that enables them to get some stunning footage that you would never be able to see if you just went to a zoo. So I really appreciated that. I liked seeing the different relationships between the animals with this fox and this crow. And I also loved the Alaskan wilderness. I mean, it just looks absolutely stunning. And the way they really traverse it is also impressive. I mean, this film doesn't take place in one field. They go all over the place and you really get a good look at the life of a bear during the summer. That said, though, my one problem with the film is that it's not particularly educational. I left the theater with more questions than answers. However, if that inspires people, like myself, to do more research about bears, then perhaps that's what the film really is all about. Piquing your interest, is serving as an introduction to these lovable, yet still dangerous, animals. Make no mistake, bears, of course, are dangerous when they feel they're threatened. We've been hearing a lot about bear attacks in the news lately, so that kind of made this documentary give it kind of a rip from the headlines kind of feel to it as well. It doesn't discuss bear attacks at all, but, you know, that was on my mind when I went to see it. And they are quite fearsome creatures. You know, after seeing Noah, and then they make quite a big deal about eating other animals in Noah, and then seeing these bears eat fish the way they eat them in this movie, even the cute little babies the way they eat fish, I was just, you know, I'm like, boy, someone's telling me to be a vegetarian. I don't know. This is tough. I'm starting to feel a little guilty about this finally. But, you know, that was my only real problem, is that I would have liked to have learned a little bit more in the actual film about bears. But as I said, quite enjoyable. John C. Reilly was a great choice to be the narrator. Not only does he have a strong voice, but there's a kindness and a playfulness to his voice and the narration he does, which really fits well with the material. So I suggest you go and see it. I think that it's a great matinee. And it's make sure you're well rested. And then also, when you do go opening weekend, if you go this coming weekend, this weekend, when it, you know, it's in theaters right now, Disney will give a portion of the box office to the National Parks Foundation. So that's a great way to spend an afternoon. It'll start a great conversation between you and those you go see the film with about bears, and you'll be doing a good thing. So this is also the first Disney nature documentary that I've seen, and I thought they did a very nice job. Well, one last thing. Over the end credits, they show some behind-the-scenes footage, which I found to be the most interesting, about how they were able to make this movie. And I would maybe hope going forward that Disney Nature would maybe do a mix where they show the wonderful footage that they're getting and then how they're getting it as the film unfolds. I would really love to see maybe a 50-50 split in the way that the approach of the film, or 60-40, 30-70, whatever. I would like to have seen. I think that would have given the film maybe a little bit more snap and make it not so warm and cozy and cuddly. So, but anyway, I do recommend you go, and it's, you know, you'd really be hard-pressed to get a better nature documentary than this in terms of the footage they were able to get. So this is a good team. They know what they're doing. So thank you so much for tuning into my review, and you can check out some more episodes right now.